There are different animals with different structures and forms, and there are million species of animals have been found till now. So there is a need for classification, and classification is very important for assigning a systematic position to the newly described species. So in this chapter, chapter 4, Animal Kingdom, we'll be studying about the basis of classification, levels of organization, symmetry, diploblastic, triploblastic organization, coelom, segmentation, notochord, and the various phylum in which the animals they are included. They are in the non-chordates as well as in the chordates. What are the different categories of animals that we are going to study in this chapter? So let's begin with the basis of classification. We know that there are differences in the structure and forms of different animals, but there is a fundamental feature that is common to various individuals in relation to the arrangement of the cells. We find that, like, body symmetry or nature of coelom, patterns of digestive circulation, reproductive system, circulatory system. So all these features are the basis of animal classification. And we'll discuss here level of organization first. Now, all animals, they are multicellular, we already know that, and they have the same pattern of organization of cells. Like in sponges, the cells, they are loosely arranged and they have cellular level of organization. And some divisions of activities they also occur in the cells. In cylindrates, the arrangement of cells is more complex, and the cells perform the same function and they are arranged into tissues. There we find the tissue level of organization is there, and still at higher level we find the organ level of organization, which is in the platyhelminthes and other higher phyla, where tissues are grouped together to form organs. And we further find when we go higher towards the other higher forms, each specialized organ, they form a particular function. And in animals like Annelida, Arthropoda, mollusks, echinoderms and chordates, the organs, they are associated to form functional systems. And each system is related to a specific function, and this pattern of organization is known as organ system level of organization. So organ system in different organisms have different patterns and complexities. The digestive system in platyhelminthes has a single opening to the outside of the body, and that serves as a both mouth and anus, and hence it is called as incomplete. Whereas a complete digestive system has two openings, mouth and anus. And this, similarly, there are other types of systems like circulatory system, which is of open or closed type. In open circulatory system, we find that the blood is pumped out of the heart and the cells and tissues are directly related to it. Whereas in the closed circulatory system, we find that the blood is circulatory through a series of vessels of different diameters, like arteries, veins, and capillaries. When we talk about symmetry, we find that animals, they are categorized on the basis of the symmetry into asymmetrical, radial, or bilateral. Asymmetrical means in any plane that passes through the center does not divide them into two equal halves. And when any plane passing through the central axis of the body divides the organism into two equal halves, then it is called as radial symmetry. You can see the diagram here. When any plane passing through the central axis of the body divides the organism into two identical halves, then it is called as radial symmetry. Cylindrates, ctenophores, echinoderms, they all have this kind of body plan. Animals like Annelida, Arthropoda, like here you can see Annelida, Arthropoda, where the body can be divided into identical left and right halves in only one plane. So that exhibits their bilateral symmetry. Diploblastic and triploblastic organization. Animals in which the cells are arranged in two embryonic layer. You can see here the two embryonic layers, an external which is called as ectoderm and an internal which is called as endoderm. They are called as diploblastic organisms. So these are diploblastic. And for example, cell entrates. So, and an undifferentiated layer which is called as mesoglia is present in between the ectoderm and the endoderm. So those animals in which the developing embryo has a third germinal layer, which is called as mesoderm, in between the ectoderm and the endoderm, they are called as triploblastic. And these can be platyhelminthes or two chordates. These are the organisms which belong to. When we talk of coelom, presence or absence of a cavity between the body wall and the gut wall is very important in classification. The body cavity which is lined by mesoderm, the body cavity which is lined by mesoderm, you can see here in the diagram, this is called as coelom. And animals possessing coelom, they are called as coelomates. Annelids, mollusks, arthropods, echinoderms, hemichordates and chordates, they all belong to this category. Now in some animals, the body cavity is not lined by a mesoderm. Instead, the mesoderm is present as scattered pouches. You can see here in the diagram, in between the ectoderm and the endoderm. And such a body cavity is called as pseudocoelom, and the animals possessing them, they are called as pseudocoelomates. Aschelminthes belongs to this category. And the animals in which the body cavity is absent, you can see here there is no cavity present here, they are called as acoelomates, and example is platyhelminthes. We also discuss about segmentation here. In some animals, the body is externally and internally divided into segments with a serial repetition of at least some organs. For example, in earthworm, the body shows this pattern which is called as metameric segmentation, and this phenomena is called as metamerism also. Notochord. Notochord is a mesodermally derived. You can see here the mesoderm. This is the mesoderm. Mesoderm se derive ho rahi hai. So notochord is a mesodermally derived rod-like structure which is formed in the dorsal side during embryonic development in some animals. So animals with the notochord, they are called as chordates, and those animals which do not form this structure, they are called as non-chordates. For example, porifera to echinoderms, okay, they all are non-chordates. Now when we talk of classification of animals, we find here animals, they are based on the common fundamental features. They are mentioned here. Animals, they are generally which are multicellular, they have level of organization, cellular and tissue, organ or organ system level of organization. Then on the basis of symmetry, they can be radial or bilateral, and on the basis of their body cavity, they can be acoelomates, pseudocoelomates or coelomates. And those which have cellular level of organization are the porifera. Coelenterates and ctenophora, they have radial symmetry. Platyhelminthes, aschelminthes, they are acoelomates and pseudocoelomates, and they have bilateral symmetry. Whereas annelida, arthropoda, mollusk, echinodermata, hemichordata and chordata, okay, they all possess bilateral symmetry, except echinodermata, they possess both radial or bilateral symmetry depending on the stage in their life cycle. Now let's talk about porifera first. Now members of this phylum, they are commonly called as sponges. They are generally marine and mostly asymmetrical. They are very primitive multicellular animals, and they have cellular level of organization. Sponges, they have a water transport or canal system. Water enters through the minute pores or ostia. You can see here in the diagram, they have minute pores or ostia. So what are ostia? These are the minute pores which are present in the body wall, which lead into the central cavity, which is called as spongocoel. What is spongocoel? It is the central cavity that is present inside these structures. Now, from where it goes through the osculum, Now, this pathway of water transport is very helpful in food gathering, respiratory exchange, and removal of the waste. Coenocytes are the collar cells. They line the spongocele and the canals, and the digestion is intracellular, that is within the cells. The body is supported by the skeleton, which is made of spicules or spongin fibers. Now, in the male and the female, they are separate, so they are not separate actually, so that is why they are called as hermaphrodite. And the eggs are sperms and produced by the same individual, and sponges, they reproduce asexually by fragmentation. Fertilization is internal and the development is indirect, having a larval stage which is morphologically distinct from the adult. Now, examples here you can see in the diagram: cycon, Eusporangia, and spongula. Cylindrates are also called as cnidaria. They are aquatic, mostly marine, and they are sessile or free living. They are radially symmetrical organisms. The name cnidaria is derived from the nidoblast or nidocytes. You can see here in the diagram. They are the stinging capsules or nematocytes which are present on the tentacles. You can see here the tentacles. They are present on the tentacles and the body. So nidoblasts, they are used for anchorage, defense, and for the capture of the prey. Cnidarians, they have tissue level of organization and they are diploblastic. They have a central gastrovascular cavity with a single opening which is called as hypostome. Digestion is extracellular, intracellular both, and some of the cnidarians, they are corals. They have a skeleton which is composed of calcium carbonate, and cnidarians, they exhibit two basic type of the forms, which are polyp and medusae. This one is sessile, it is stationary, and cylindrical form like hydra, adamsia, and this one is umbrella like. You can see here. This one is umbrella-like, this adamsia, which is a polyp, and Aurelia, which is medusae. You can see here, this is umbrella-like. So, these cnidarians which exhibit both forms, they have alternation of generations, which is called as metagenesis. So, polyps produce medusae asexually, and medusae form the polyps sexually, for example, Obelia. Now, examples are Physalia, Adamsia, sea anemone, Pernatula, that is sea pen, Gorgonia, that is sea fen, and Meandrina, that is brain coral. So these are some of the examples of this type. Next we see phylum Ctenophora. Ctenophora, it is commonly known as sea walnuts or palm jellies, and they are marine, radially symmetrical, diploblastic organisms. And with the tissue level of organization, the body has external rows of cells which are called as comb plates. And they help in the locomotion. So digestion is both extracellular and intracellular. They have bioluminescence. You can see here. Bioluminescence means what? The property to emit light. And it is well marked in the Ctenophores. The sexes are not separate and reproduction takes place only by the sexual means, and fertilization is external and they have indirect development. Example is Pleurobrachia and Ctenophora. This is Pleurobrachia, which is shown here. Ctenoplana is another example.